طيب، يعطيكم العافية.
Hello everyone.
يعني يسعدني ويشرفني
I'm
أن
really happy and honored
بمشاركة
to
الأستاذ
present this
تاهي
the paper of my friend Faisal Darraj,
المتواجد حاليا في
who's currently
عمان الأردن،
in Amman, Jordan.
لاجئ من الجعونة.
He's a refugee from Jauna.
عنوان
The title of
مناسبة الحديث
of the
بالنسبة لهم
presentation of Mr. Faisal is a decline of the Palestinian popular
أكثر
awareness. I would read
عن
this
ما يحدث
paper and then I would
ابن المنظمين الأستاذ أحمد
ask
ببعض
Mr. Ahmad and the
الملاحظات المسلية.
organizers. I will share some comments on the paper.
يستلزم العنوان الذي لا تفاؤل به
This title, which is not
سبحان الله
optimistic, requires
يعكس
standing before three
تراكم
phenomena.
الصراع
The
بيسري
general decline that characterizes the
بالمعلومات
Palestinian national reality in its
السياسية،
basic joint by political organizations or what or
وتصاعد
the
الأزمات
so-called organizations
الاقتصادية
which
الفلسطينية
promised once to unify the Palestinian people and lead them
والتصاعد على
forward
مناطق
and
أرضية
supervise
جديدة،
their future in making this
وارتاحت إلى
future
شعارات عالية
and were
الصوت
satisfied with loud slogans that were
ضمنت
empty of
الشعبية
content which included the popular and democratic and revolutionary as well as the Arab and sometimes equated all the slogans and established them on a perspective that is the basis of liberation, which means a new revival for the Palestinians, which unleashes all his creative potential and makes him subsequently worthy of belonging to his cause and victory. However, these organizations, which generated after the historic defeat of June 1967, failed in what they promised and even retreated from that and turned into formal nominal structures characterized by stagnation and incapable stagnation and became an obstacle to what they promised. So they are neither, at least now, popular nor democratic, and their liberation dimension has fallen since it neglected the issue of women, culture, and effective national unity that is built by responsible dialogue, integration of rights and duties, criticism, self-criticism, and competition in reviewing and reviving the national issues raised. The verse of national decline, which is necessarily political, and what we derive from it in terms of the decline of popular awareness is evident in the simulation of the Arab authoritarian situation, which is characterized by decline in turn, as if Palestinian life, political life, if the expression is correct, were an extension of vital life in which there is no politics. If the extinction of politics in the Arab world is explained by the duality of corruption and tyranny and the dominance of fear and silence, then its extinction, this extinction in Palestine is explained even to some extent by the dissolution of the supposed political references, which are tragic both in appearance and in essence, since neither the political entity that supervises the national work is apparent in its effect, nor the approach to liberating the homeland exists, and all that exists is a formal authority centered in Ramallah, which gives the illusion that it's an authority like other Arab authorities, but it is not an authority since the former has devoted its capabilities to the renewed preservation of authority. Therefore, probably the Palestinian situation context is catastrophic or disastrous because it has failed to show the Palestinian action and the Palestinian organizational groups recognized the national center. Therefore, it is okay to speak about the political collapse of the Palestinian national project that is between the people and the leadership. Even though there are so many martyrs are still being and there are parties who are defending Palestine, but both things are not going under in the Palestinian Liberation Project for two reasons. The national work that expresses the work, the collective work that goes beyond the factions and parties does not exist. There are some factions that are affiliated to Palestine, but there are no Palestinian united parties or factions. If these organizations are not, they would lead to the fragmentation of the Palestinian work. Of course, there are some quotes and expressions that I can't express here. The other reason, there's a weird equation about and a real challenge between the military operations in confronting the Zionist project. So there is no way to liberate the country without a political, collective intellectual project that liberates the ideologies while uniting the comprehensive Palestinian struggle history, starting with the demonstrations of Jerusalem and back in 1920 through 1929 and the revolution and the revolution of 1936 and the armed resistance in the middle of the 60s. The word of the resistance is the only one that is really heard in this context. Throughout the Palestinian struggle in its various decades, should consult and be enlightened by the sacrifices of the Palestinians, starting with Azad al-Qassam, Abdel Qader Hussaini, to Ghassan Tarafani, to Nadia al-Aji, and the poetry of Mahmoud Darwish, and the stories of Azam and others. The popular national political work is renewed, and it's the one that unites the Palestinian history of struggle history. The Palestinian struggle is the struggle of a people and not the struggle of factions or parties. It's a historical long one that does not accept the division or partition. It's a free ideology that that it is self-educated and learns from the it continues to be enlightened due to the to keep the history of the Palestinian struggle in its renewed relationship. It is the reference of the Palestinian national awareness. Therefore, we would ask, what's the difference between the Palestinian awareness we may ask, what is the position of the Palestinian popular awareness in administrative practices that speak in the name of the homeland and have the features of a deal? The most present and painful question is, if there had been any collective national work, would the Palestinian situation have ended up where it has today? Or searching, or the, while the other one is Israeli looking after the interests and enjoying the loyalty and the affiliations, it's a horrible one, it's a bad one. You would no official can ask about the actual interest, given that the blind interest thinks that it's the truth, and outside of it, whatever is outside is only against the fake legitimacy or that is based on the Arab blood, the national blood that objects the oppression of the Palestinian people and the suffering. Since we are, as we are talking about the retract or the decline of the popular awareness, we need to think positively about the how it used to be before that. I mean, the diverse and the multi factions or groups that had their different and the different intellectuals, the different factions, and before the educated people or the intellects would be more loyal to money, their role was, they used to have a role in writing and or involving in dialogues between the economy or the culture, especially with professional intellectuals, and to work against the ambiguity and make things more clear and less costly. Probably Ghassan Kanafani is a picture. Perhaps Ghassan Kanafani was and still is an image of the Palestinian national intellectual who addresses the message who believes in, and they exchange trust, purposes, and recognition, as well as Najil Ali, who appointed himself as a spokesperson for the truth and spontaneous popular awareness. Given the effectiveness of both parties and their role in awakening the masses and engaging in dialogue with them, the Zionist enemy assassinated the first and an internal enemy with some difference assassinated the second. The image of the negative intellectual who unites organizational loyalty and the monthly allowance dominated, as the first is a guarantor of privileges and jobs and the second is a tool of oppression, seduction and mischief. In fact, the Palestinian National Action is read in its first goals, which promised liberation and the recovery of Palestine, and sometimes went too far and saw itself as an Arab vanguard leading the Palestinians and all the Arabs before those who said so became another image of official Arab political life, which is characterized by death and hostility to liberation, whether individual or societal. The Palestinian administrative official imitation of the Arab official led to the extinction of politics and culture together, and to the siege of popular awareness and the fear of the autonomy of the popular political movement. And evidence of that is the outcome of the first Palestinian Intifada uprising at the end of the 80s of the last century, which constituted a distinct bright spot in the Palestinian struggle and in which women played a vital role. The various organizations rushed to stifle this intifada or uprising and sabotage its spontaneous leadership. Some of us are, there is a difference between language, some language typos. So he's using now, they rushed actually. Some of us adhere to the duality of the follower and the followed, as it is the beginning and end of the national work, and some saw the role of women as an unbearable burden, the first embodied oppression based on Mr. President, who put in his pockets the political secrets and monthly allowances, and some later reduced national work to the dichotomy of believers and non-believers. Here we ask, what is the meaning of national liberation if the allowance is a guarantee of practice and loyalty? And what is this practice whose correctness is guaranteed by an expected monthly allocation? What are the horizons of liberation that stand above those who measure degrees of faith in military operations, whether they are reckless or calculated? And what is the difference between the Palestinian awareness and others if the reference does not need geography and history and dissolves into an abstract generality whose basis is faith, which sees in national independence with a defined identity and encroachment and apostasy? The Palestinian national work has known from its beginning what suppresses free choice. The monthly allocation or allowance was not limited to individuals, but also included subordinate organizations that had to accept a primary reference that distributed allowances or allocations to the organizations that accepted it. This is why the term National Front, which was known by multiple liberation movements, remained expelled from Palestinian national life. There has always been a single decision maker and reference, and this continued to this day, despite the differences in conditions and possibilities or capacities. Within such limits, popular awareness either relies on its own efforts or resorts to daily media and naive comments, or is subject to a will that tames, distorts, and monopolizes it. It's not the talk today in the name of Palestinian was subject to a single place and a single official with his disloyal companies or companions who share with it the silence, the absence of effort, dialogue, and corruption as well. The confusion that accompanied the Oslo Agreement indicates a political administration preoccupied with its own destiny, the way the agreement was achieved, the tools that contributed to its formulation, and the sarcastic ambiguity that surrounded it all announced a deficient administration obsessed with preserving its positions as if these positions were a profession that generates rent and a privilege that cannot be relinquished. The political performance that formulated the Oslo Accords does not surprise anyone, as the controlling institution is addicted to reducing facts to the fact of a senior official, where self-criticism, like collective decision, seems filthy and close to treason. Perhaps the absence of self-criticism, like collective work, made the agreement deal exist before it was established. We may ask, what is the position of the Palestinian popular awareness in administrative practices that speak in the name of the homeland and have the features of a deal? The most present and painful question is, if there had been collective national work, would the Palestinian situation have ended up where it has today, with Palestine reduced to a voice that does not know how to speak and that compromises and in order to maintain its position? The abolition of politics in official administrative work was reflected in preserving the traditions of the individual, the elite, that supports him, and the individual references that are subservient. This bankrupt work covered itself with a pre-verbalism consisting of the right of return Palestine and its capital Jerusalem as its capital, the blood of the martyrs and the spirit of Palestine. Thus, politics, which is a liberation transformational act, turned into a traditional act that is anti-liberation and different from that. Popular consciousness does not come from itself as or out of the blue, as there are necessary elements on which it relies, the first of which is effective societal dialogue, collective cultural action, renewed self-criticism, and recognition of the role of women, which does not need recognition because it exists by necessity. There is also a cultural political policy entrusted with unifying the Palestinians in the diaspora and highlighting a clear and integrated national point of view, even if relatively. Today, the Palestinian popular consciousness is, or awareness in its true sense, comes from opposing the loose practices that speak in the name of the Palestinian cause, embodied in a group that no one elected, because it inherited a negatively that was based on elevating the sole official and still is. It is self-evident that Palestinian national awareness comes from the practical struggle against the Zionist enemy, far from Palestinian references, cold leaders who are comfortable with calm and stability and undisturbed relations with the Israeli enemy. This is the end of this presentation of Mr. Faisal. Please allow me to introduce some or to share some comments. I would like to make some comments, two comments actually. The first one, if we remove the period regarding Oslo, if we remove it from this presentation, would this presentation be good to read any period of time ever since the PLO was launched? And why did, the question, why did Mr. Faisal Darraj preferred or to be distant from all the aspects of the reality which is active in the formation of the Palestinian culture and criticizing it? This is my first comment. The second one reminds us of an intervention by Mr. Faisal Darraj before the culture of arguments or dialogue was vanished in the Palestinian culture, which is part of the Arab culture. And that is actually an intervention by Mr. Faisal commenting on the book of Mahdi Amer, The Colonial Production. He asked some verbal and some questions, political questions. The response or the reply was by Mr. Faisal Darraj, by Mahdi Amer, that Mr. Faisal read another book. He commented on it, and it's not the colonial production pattern book and the civil war. And based on these two comments, my question is, or maybe some questions, first to Mr. Faisal Darraj, and to contribute to the discussion. The first one is a formal question based on the Mr. Faisal's questions to Mahdi Amer. Why did Faisal Darraj choose the political popular language and the decisive political language? Why did he said the internal enemy? He almost called it the internal enemy that assassinated Najil Ali and Nizar Banat, who has another name. So why didn't he use the name? This is the talk about the Palestinian organization, the PLO and or the PA. So this is the first aspect of, we would not refrain from also mentioning the political force at the Palestinian arena that is not incorporated, or that doesn't come under the PLO. The resistance is a key word used only one time in the presentation, and it is referred to only a historical aspect, which is the continuation of the revolution until the launching of the PLO. In terms of diagnosis, I think
وكمان باستعارة من مهدي عامر في رده على
using مهدي عامر's response to Faisal Darraj, it's as if Mr. Faisal read another reality or situation, not a different book this time, but a different reality. Where is the criticism of Mr. Faisal about the total or entire collapse? He's talking about the national movement since the building or the establishment of the PLO. This leads to other questions. With the exception of the criticism of the authoritarian structure of the Palestinian Authority, there is no criticism of the national movement in its traditional manner, as well as the genocide war in Gaza and against Lebanon in Palestine is absent all the culture produced and leading to the Palestinian resistance movements and Arab resistance movements and their incubators and environments. This is absent in the presentation. At a verbal level, there's another important question that has to do with how we see the Palestinian intellectual today, whether trained within the conventional national framework. It's also the question that Mr. Faisal Darraj asked to Mahdi Amir, if the political practice is on the ground, why should we write theories? I think he meant Mahdi Amir in the Lebanese Communist Party. So since you are practicing revolution on the ground, why speak, why come up with the theories? Today we would ask an intellectual who's wearing the preacher, has no political incubator to speak through, nor a practice on the ground. So where does this intellectual stand, or where can this preacher, intellectual preacher, practice his actively his in his political party? And if the or if the resentment of the resistance is confined to faith, this could be another question. And at a critical level, Mr. Faisal Darraj continued his important critique and the concept of the Palestinian rural intellectual in the revolutionary or in the movement, the struggle movements, and so this critique is okay, but to me it seems that Mr. Faisal doesn't see three types of intellectuals that were not included in this absent culture probably in the past 40 years, starting with the first Intifada or uprising. And so far, the first intellectual is the Islamic or the Islamist intellectual. We're not talking about imams at the that Jum'ah. We were talking about intellectuals who's been also represented or the other type of intellectual is the son of the Islamist culture, is the son of the Arab culture, and the culture that is produced in prisons, the Palestinian prisoner movement, which is strong and which is also a leader, which is leading an important part of the popular culture and is inspiring. Actually, I mean the popular awareness that the culture, I'm sorry, I think there is a problem here. We mean the popular awareness as opposed to culture in the presentation. There's a difference. So the third intellectual who tries to unify these two currents or these two aspects or the feeders that takes us to an important place tries to produce this intellectual that Faisal Darraj talks about, we talk about a productive intellectual in confronting not only the Zionist project, but in confronting the Palestinian project that Mr. Faisal described and defined. The last question, at an ethical level, Mr. Faisal also taught us in his reading of the ideology, the European ideology, or the Frankfurt School, which he describes as the Marxist, or the Jew who spiritualized the Marxism. We don't want a Palestinian to spiritualize the PLO or to make it more faith-based. Faith is seen as an accusation against the Islamist movement. We cannot make a copy of those who were victorious in order to achieve victory. But as Palestinians, they seek to find salvation, which is different from the salvation of the Jews of Europe that were given the salvation project by Zionism. We cannot resort to their resolutions, but we need a group of intellectuals from all three tributaries to contribute to this salvation project today, and or maybe not today. I mean not today. I mean before the war and after the division, also back in 2006, the first charter, the first prisoner charter, the first political prisoner movement that invites the does not call for political solutions, like one to give consideration, to give back the consideration to the liberation option. For example, Marwan Barghouti, Ahmed Saadat, Atallah, and Haider Eid, Rifat Al-Alul. We need to see what is their perception of the national national redemption or salvation project, and it's a separate project. We continue to call for this project. Thank you.